Welcome back to Design Bundle's YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal, and I'm going to show you guys how to use alternate glyphs inside of Procreate. So have you guys installed a font or purchased a font that has these really cool glyphs, but you don't know how to use them inside of Procreate? Now currently there is no way to use glyphs right inside of Procreate, but you can do this using a third-party app. The third-party app that we're going to be using today is Unicode Character Viewer. This is only 99 cents, and this is going to allow us to bring those alternate glyphs right inside of Procreate. So for 99 cents, you're going to finally be able to utilize those. Now, hopefully in the future, Procreate will come up with an update where we can do that right inside of Procreate. So let me go ahead and show you how this is done. So we've got our blank canvas just as we normally would. We're going to go up here to the wrench and we're going to add text, which is right here, just like normal. So I'm going to go ahead and double tap this and then we're going to hit keyboard. We're going to hit that double A and we're going to search for our font. So mine is called Memories. I'll have this link down below. So it's right here. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and type this out. So let's go back to that keyboard and I'm going to do Design Bundles. All right, so now let's go ahead and head on into our app. All right, so this is the very front screen you're gonna come to for the Unicode Character Viewer. So what we wanna do is hit Browse Fonts, and I'm gonna search for this font. Now I have it right here at Recent, but I could definitely just go to Search and type in Memories, and it'll pop up right here. So now you guys can see all of this stuff right here inside. You can see which pieces you can utilize. So for example, let's go ahead and use this D right here that has this nice little swoosh here. So let's do this one. So what you're gonna do is this little box right here that has that arrow up, we're gonna click on that and then we're gonna hit share glyph. At this point, we're gonna go ahead and hit copy and we're ready to go back to Procreate. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and select that D, and what you wanna do is tap it twice and it's gonna pop this box up right here. You don't want to double tap, you're just going to tap it twice. And now what we can do is hit paste. So I can now go back and delete this one. And now you can see that we have that really nice D. So let's go ahead and do that one more time. For the next one, I want to do this S right here on the end. So we're going to go ahead and click it here. We're going to do the same thing. We're hitting that box with the arrow up. We're going to hit share glyph. We're going to hit copy. And then we're going to go back to Procreate. We're going to go ahead and click here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and tap twice and then hit paste. So let's go ahead and delete the other S. So I'm happy with this, it looks great. I was able to use my alternate glyphs. Once you're done, you can simply go ahead and size that out and work with it just as usual. So there you guys have it. You guys can see how cool this was. We were able to bring those glyphs right inside of Procreate using the third-party app. Now, if you guys have any issues when you first go to use that app and you notice that your fonts aren't coming in, what you need to do is go to your settings. From here, what you're looking for is general and then profile. So from here, you're gonna notice those fonts right here. So what you need to do is click on that font, and then at that point, you're gonna see an install button. Now this is already installed, but you're gonna notice an install button right here. Once you hit install, it's gonna be ready to go. Now another tip is I would go ahead and duplicate this layer right away in case you decide to go back and edit any more. So what you're gonna do is just click your layers, slide over and hit that duplicate. So that way you're gonna have this two times. So that way whatever you do to the first layer, you decide you don't like that, you can just simply delete it and come back to your original layer. And that's how easy it is to use those alternate glyphs. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.